Alright, here we go again. On our way to public execution. Yeah, I'm controlling Barrett for now. Me and T-Far being escorted to our death. Damn, Shinra. It's not enough that the world is ending. I can understand, you know, the desire to control the populace by any way, many means necessary during a crisis and stuff, but come on, man. You know, Scarlet, yeah. Is everyone here? These are the ones who brought this madness into the world.
The hell are these people?
We will be broadcasting your miserable deaths live on national television.
Reporter. Scarlet, why a public execution in this day and age?
With the chaos resulting from the meteor reports, we desperately need to rally the public support. It's better that we punish somebody. Anybody! You make me sick. They'll never admit it, but everyone loves this stuff. We'll start with this girl.
If you're gonna do it, do me first. God damn it.
Camera, this way. Make sure you get this. The audience just eats up tearful goodbye.
Damn it. Oh, shit. God. You son of a bitch.
What are you doing? This is my special gas chamber. Take your time and enjoy a slow, painful death.
Scarlet's mad strong.
Stuck up, cunt!
Oh, lucky. Lucky, lucky, lucky.
Well now, the show is about to begin!
Emergency! Emergency! Weapons approaching! Attention all! Military personnel, take your positions! Oh no, it's weapon!
Run!
Hey, all of you! Damn, why now?
How does it feel now, Scarlet?
Hmm? So you didn't run? I'm impressed. How do I feel right now?
Sleeping gas?
Oh, hell yeah!
Weirdo!
Yeah, is Barry gonna help with his arms tied behind his back?
Oh yeah, he don't care.
Yeah, too bad Kate Sith has not been kept up to date. But I don't think these encounters have been designed with that in mind. Whenever they take, like, that sort of direct kind of approach where they decide who's going to be in your party, I think there has to be some kind of leeway built in. So that if you have, like, a character you really don't care for, I don't mean that I don't care for Kate Sith, but... if you had a character like that, for example, with me, Vincent, because of his limit breaks, is kind of character like that. If I was forced to take him along, he couldn't be like absolute garbage because I hadn't been using him.
I'm done. I'm here to help.
Why you? Ain't you part of Shinra?
Let's just say I'm against capital punishment. Besides, I hate this broad. Come on, man, we gotta get help. We gotta help Tifa.
I'll help watch at the entrance.
Oh, yeah.
Fools! I've already pushed the switch.
You son of a bitch! Let's just go to the door. It won't open!
Yeah, the weapon's coming. The weapon's super cool. I like kaiju stuff quite a bit.
It's weapon!
There's been so many attacks lately. Can we handle it?
I believe so. Your orders.
No need to ask.
We'll give it a shot from the big cannon. Open cannon doors. Activate cannon. Target weapon.
My favorite of the weapons is the big, bulky, white-colored one. He's gonna come in later. But this one, I can't remember the names of a lot of the weapons, but this weapon is like an aquatic type. You saw pretty much all of them in the cutscene when they awoke, but it's easy to just kind of think that some of them are the same because they kind of look...
Preparations complete!
The cannon... Fire!
Atmospheric stuff. Silence before the storm. Did we get him?
Seems so.
Weapon approaching! It's heading right towards us. Speed, 50 knots.
I can't be. We hit it dead on.
How about the cannon?
I'll take time to reload.
Then use regular firepower in the meantime.
Yes, sir. Open all artillery doors. Target weapon. Don't let it land.
Fuck yeah. Man, I'm getting goosebumps.
Speed, 70 knots. Weapon closing in. No good, it's attacking us.
Line of defense. Morale still keeping. It's like, you know, just the kind of kinetic force of it just ramming forward. Ain't nothing stopping it.
She! The gas room's probably locked from a different room.
We gotta go with a different plan. Let's get out of this room first.
Tifa, I'll help you. I promise.
Fools! Now you can't save the girl!
God damn it!
Okay, time for plan B. Let's run to the airport.
Why the airport? Ain't leaving Tifa here!
Trust me, we gotta take the chance.
Son of a bitch, is it this way? I guess so.
Oh, wait. Oh, yeah, she's disguised, but there's no mistaking. That's yuppie. Especially after, like, Kate Sith was in disguise. You ain't fooling me. My memory is not that great when it comes to a lot of things about this game, but I ain't a dummy. Beat their ass. Because, yeah, Kate Sith doesn't have any materia on him, but I'm sure they built these encounters with that in mind. Because, you know, somebody might not have had a Barret as their regular either, so.
Sword of Doom! Doom!
Like Invader Zim would say. That's one of those series, I don't think I ever want to return to it because I have such fond memories of it, and I feel like I might dispel that if I went and watched Invader Zim as an adult. But yeah, there's a lot of things like that. Alright. I don't know how many fights there's left, so yeah, I need to make sure to heal myself. I think Barret did have healing materia, but also, of course, I have, like, potions and stuff. No, he doesn't. Okay, so let's just... one potion, but high potions are aplenty. Yeah, because I haven't been using... I have, like, 60 X potions and stuff. That's what it's like.
I know you're in a hurry, but please, if I could have a word...
Shut up! I'm in a hurry!
Key! Don't make so much noise! It's me, Yuffie!
Yeah, I recognize you.
The hell you doing here?
Has like a shield over or something. It's holding like a... like a Dracula cloak, like, hey, bleh!
I'll explain later! Now we gotta go get to the airport!
Well, good. Yuffie, I think I have a good point because I did the whole Wu-Tai optional boss battle stuff.
Baturu!
More of the same. Oh, a single guy.
She didn't die. Kaboom.
There you go. And nothing to worry about. Nothing at all. There you go. They leveled up a little bit.
Bang. Get to the airship. Yo, you sure this is the right way? It's a dead end.
Uh-oh, did I make a wrong turn?
You damn cat! What the hell are we gonna do now? They're all coming soon. Yo, better watch my back to the end, partner.
Barrett's looking to go, like, out in a blaze of glory. Move your feet and arms, then use your head to get out of the chair. Oh, I don't know if she was talking to herself. Yeah, there's legs, left, right arm, and head. Okay, so legs will likely reach the key. There you go. Okay, okay. Well, does she need to, like... Okay, now she went, like, back, legs. Oh, there you go. Oh, okay. Try different patterns. Try to combine two movements at once. Well, if my arms are tied, let's press these two at the same time. Yeah, there you go. And then let's one of the arms and mouth. There, and let's then the arms there. Which button stops the gas? Oh, fuck.
Spion.
There you go. Whew. Held her breath pretty damn well. Oh. Open.
Mega Smasher!
Nice. Not that powerful. I would have thought it would have been a lot more like a... Oh, shit. I mean, yeah, it's a weapon. It's like a monster built by the planet to protect itself against Genova-style threats. But come on. Close range battle. What do you do? Open it! First you lock me in this weird place, and now you're telling me to come out? Make up your mind! Oh, they're coming behind me. And he died. Oh, shit. Oh, my hip. No worries, just run like nothing just happened. You know, it's Cloud wasn't like the only one who could like you'd see people still like justified it like oh well he fell onto a flower bed, you know, like as if that would have made a difference, but no, it's an anime trope. It's fun that the player characters are super strong and powerful and they can like survive anything in this kind of Dragon Ball Z kind of way. But at the same time, you want to tell stories that are relatable. So if two guards are holding you by the arms and Scarlet punches you, you still, like, fall to your knees because that's, you know, you're creating drama. But I can definitely understand if people have a problem with that sort of internal inconsistency, that you could, like, punch a god in the face, but if like, a Scarlet punches you, you're like, oh! Like, you fold, like a paper or something, I don't know.
our little game of hide-and-seek ends here. The execution may have been unsuccessful, but your death by falling from here and crashing in the water below still might be pretty exciting. Oh, shit. What did Five Fingers say to the face? Slap! Stuck up, bitch! Quit slapping me, you old wench!
Push the circle button. Push the circle button.
Slap! 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 Slap!
No! I got like a... Ooh, there you go.
Slap! Slap!
Oh, yeah, hell yeah.
God, I can't stand it! Take her away.
Oh, yes, ma'am.
Now it's time to pay up. I'll really drop you if you don't settle down. Run. Run to the end of the cannon.
Yeah, I'm guessing she was hearing like Cloud or Ares or somebody in her head. Can't be sure. It's always funny to see these kinds of, like, there's the well-made cutscenes, there's the ones where it's just the game graphics, but this between thing where it's like the game graphics but a little bit better, you know, done. It's cute. But yeah, like, after falling from that great height and not caring, you know, like, not caring at all, and then right after that, Scarlet threatens to push you into the water. It's like, into the water? You know? You think that's gonna hurt me?
You okay?
My cheeks hurt a bit. Forget about that. What's all this about?
Well, I'll catch the details later. In any case, the airship Highwind is now yours.
Hey, Yuffie.
Well, I'm glad you're safe. I'm gonna stay up here for a little longer.
Oh, hell yeah. Hell yeah. Wouldn't be a proper Final Fantasy game if you didn't get an airship at some point.
My hands are full, so I'll excuse myself here.
Fly airship. Chew the fat?
Well, what should I talk about? Wanna hear why we rebelled?
Listen.
Working on the Highwind, we spent every day slaving under Heidegger. Whenever we got yelled at by the president, he'd immediately take it out on the crew. We put up with this all the time, even when he beat us. I mean, I finally made it on the crew of the famous Highwind, and there's no way I was going to quit over him. Let's see, it must be a week ago. It was my shift, and we were heading towards the North Cave. Everyone, including the President and Scarlet, got on, and with them, I saw Sid, a legendary pilot. And he was looking around the inside of the ship, looking really, you know, nostalgic. He even talked to us. I couldn't believe it. I was so impressed. He was every bit as warm-hearted as we've always heard.
Sid, warm-hearted? I guess he kind of shifts when he gets on board an airship, you know? Sid said that if we had the high wind, if he had the high wind, things would be a lot easier. And now, here we are, off to save the planet. It's true. He really overwhelmed me. And that's why we decided to help. After the North Gate, we went to Junon, and I started screaming, "Fire! Fire!" In the middle of all the commotion, we stole the ship from the Shinra. That's how it happened. Just a minor mutiny against our leaders. But Barrett and you were captured by Heidegger. We waited 7 days for a chance to rescue you guys before we finally could. So thanks to our successful mission, we were able to see you again. I hope I didn't bore you too much with that long story. No, thanks for adding the continuity of all that happened during the 7 days that Tifa was under. Sorry, go speak to Captain Sid. Captain Sid, hell yeah. Operations room. It's like the captain's...
I'll see you in my ready room. T. Earl Grey, hot.
I'm bored. I'd like to ride a chocobo.
Phew!
He wasn't looking forward to explaining it to us. But yeah, I guess when you get into like breeding chocobos for chocobo racing and stuff, it'll be stored there. Cockpit.
Damn it! Why didn't you tell me you could fly an airship? I thought Tifa was gone for good.
Sorry, but I had to do something to trick the enemy. Come on, everyone is waiting.
Everyone? Everyone's here? Well, I know certain someone isn't, but...
Welcome to my airship, the High Wind, son. What's wrong, son? You should be more excited than that.
Sid.
Oh, yeah!
Not enough crew.
Tifa, I'll give you information on Shinra. Ask me if there's anything you don't understand.
Ah, okay. I was such thinking that I could have asked him about it. Oh. Hey, crew. Pilot in training, level 3.
Yee-hoo! Don't talk to me right now! Woo-hoo!
Do you think we are strong enough without Cloud? Do you think we can't save the planet alone?
Meteor is coming, and a weapon is on the rampage. At a time like this, I don't know what I'm supposed to do. No idea at all. That's kind of becoming a theme with Tifa.
Get a hold of yourself, Tifa. Come on, let's think about this. No way we can get off of this train we're on.
If only Cloud was here, everything would be fine. Cloud would stand that cocky little way he did and tell us what to do. He'd say, "Everything's under control, Tifa."
Tifa, when'd you become such a wimp?
I'm sorry, Barrett. I'm kind of shocked. I'm kind of shocked myself. I'm so depressed.
And Tifa, there's a reason why you...
Oh, sorry, that was...
And Tifa, there's a reason why we all thought it was Cloud. It was Cloud, was because...
I know. That's why I want to make sure. That's why I have to see him again.
So,
glad you're all right, Tifa.
Vincent doesn't have a lot to say, you know.
Look in the eye of a chicken and you will see the enormity of the flat brain, the intensity of stupidity.
Cheer up, Tifa.
I want you to know that I didn't dislike him. Gotta admit, he was a strange dude, son. Just when you thought he was cool, he'd go and do some damn fool thing. And when you thought he was smart, he'd show just how stupid he was. And that's the bottom line. Everything about him, from his movements to his speech, were kind of odd. Knowing what I do now, I can see why he was that way, son. Well, as long as you stay alive, you just might see him again someday. So cheer up, sis!
I'll be able to see him someday.
If we can find out where he is, the high wind will get us there in no time, son.
Maybe. Cloud is still stuck deep in the north crater, where the ground cracked and swallowed him up. Buried in the depths of the underground.
Deep within the earth? Are you talking about the life stream?
The life stream sometimes gushes out to the surface from cracks in the ocean floor. I heard that such a place exists. Maybe, just maybe, Clouds.
Where?
Cheer up, Tifa.
Okay, Sid.
If we can find out where he is, the high wind will get us there in no time, son.
All right. Piloting training.
Woohoo! Captain Sid!
Tifa, sorry, but I gotta show this moron how to land the ship, son. Don't worry, it'll be done in a minute. Oh, and Tifa, no matter what your goal is, you've got to be prepared. Go to your room and get ready for our operation, son.
To my room? Does he mean the ready room? I'm sure there's going to be like a safe point there or something where I can use the PHS. And with that, I'll be able to like pick a team. Or do I use this? Or do I talk to him?
Tifa, thank you for a job well done.
Yeah. Alright, so it's going to be Barrett and it's going to be Sid. Let's just see. I don't think I got any new equipment, but let's just see what the materia situation is. Oh yeah, I gave a lot of stuff away, and of course, Cloud is no longer with us. So, Neo Bahamut to restore all time. That's fine. She can hold on to that. Barrett is gonna have... He has basically garbage right now. I'll need to like basically rearrange almost entirely this whole thing. So let's have Barrett have the restore all. Where's the restore? And I missed it again. Not revive. I have a couple of restores. Wait a minute. Restore all. Enemy turtle pump ice. Added effect. Bahamut Earth. Enemy skill. Ramu Ifrit. That seems fine. Restore all. So, okay. If Tifa has the haste all, he has. Sid has restore all. Then I'll just. I don't know why I don't have the other restore. Oh, no, 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 that's why. Yeah, demo me, just saw it here. Tifa doesn't need restore because I'm gonna give Barret the restore so that I have two guys that can restore all. That's the idea. Did I just miss it again? Jeez Louise. Restore, then he has to have Big Pig. Let's have him have counterattack, cover. Odin, lightning, fire. He already has cover. I don't want to give cover to either Cid or Tifa right now. Enemy skill, Titan, luck plus. Let's just see if there's anything I kind of wish I... Another fire, Leviathan. I think... Yeah, I'll give... And I have a sneaking suspicion that this is all gonna go differently in the near future. Again, Leviathan, and did Cid already have fire, ice, earth? Okay, he'll get the other fire. I think I'm good. I think I'm good with this bunch and this setup. And if the time comes that I have to like rearrange stuff again, I'll just... My camera has been sloping down. Can't have none of that. Can't have none of that. It's like my setup is so like kind of silly and stupid and kind of arts and crafts. This kind of style, it's like, you know, please don't slow down, Mr. Camera. Please don't slow down. Yeah, like, I'm having technical difficulties, but hopefully it'll hold. All right, everything's there, ready. All right.
How we going?
We're going.
We're off.
He's like the... I can't remember the name of the song, but the one where the cowboy is, like, screeching, like, in the landscape of mountains and stuff. I know where Cloud washed up into. Into Indonesia. Okay, yeah. Circle makes me go onward. So, yeah. It was kind of poorly expressed in the dialogue. But this is the first time, you know, you've had this little dot on the map for ages now. And, you know, if anybody wondered what this place was, it's like, yeah, now you can go there. This is when you need to go there. But from what Red 13 said, I mean, my intuition would have been, if I was playing this for the first time, to go to the crater to... Look for Cloud there, but the live stream is a stream. It goes all around the planet underneath the Earth's crust. And, you know, if he says that it washes up somewhere, why not on the other side of the planet, you know? But this is, again, like a classic moment where I think it's expected of any new player that they would just kind of roam around and revisit a lot of places wondering where they need to go. But I remember Indonesia.
Ahoy! Hey, ain't you a beaut? This here's Medeal.
Mid-eel. Alright.
Medeal, it's a quiet little hot springs town.
Well, hot springs town makes sense.
Just the perfect place for old folks like us to live out our lives. I hear that things ain't so peaceful on the outside, but here, it's still nice and quiet.
That looks like an item shop. Yeah, somebody's training a chocobo, I see.
But anyhow, that overgrown moon is going to fall down on us, isn't it? This no joke, when we got to start stocking up on supplies before they're all gone, out of the way! Hey, move it!
No, she's not, like, training, she's doomsday prepping.
Welcome,
we always welcome cars. Now, about here... Now, about where you want to go. I'm afraid other customers have already booked it up where there's nothing left. Just kidding. Just a little joke. Now, what can I do for you?
Fantastic sense of humor. Let's get two of these, just so that I'm in a satisfying number of 10. The remedy cures abnormal status. Let's get like 5 of those. Tranquilizer. I have pretty... Yeah. No need for that stuff. I think this time...
Oh, thank you, come again!
I think this time, when I go weapon shopping, I'm gonna sell all the weapons I have.
Oh, doggy! Oh, what's the matter? Are you all alone? You got lost, didn't you? Separated from someone you love? Silly thing.
Yes, it's been about a week now since he washed up here on the shore. Poor pokey-headed young thing. It was really sad, but weird. He was holding his really long sword. I don't know, the whole thing feels unlucky to me. But the amazing thing was those weird blue eyes.
What? Wait a minute. What did you just say? Excuse me, that young person you were just talking about?
Yeah, a villager found him a little ways down the coast. It was about a week ago, I think.
Yeah, poor kid. He must have drifted from somewhere pretty far away.
Cloud! It must be! It's Cloud!
You sure?
Good job, Tifa!
So where is he? Is he safe? Where is he now?
Up ahead here, at the, clinic.
He's alive! Cloud! Cloud's alive! Cloud!
Yo, Tifa!
Tifa kind of let it slip when she was talking to the dog. Separated from somebody you love.
Cloud!
You know, the way you're running around here, you'd think Meteor fell or something.
I'm sorry, but I heard that a friend of mine was being taken care of here.
A friend? Oh yeah, that young fellow. Don't worry, your friend is next door. But I'm afraid his condition is...
Here? Over here? Cloud! Oh, Cloud, I'm so glad you're safe. Huh? Cloud? What's wrong, Cloud? Cloud, what happened to you?
Quite an advanced case. It appears the young man's been exposed to high level of Mako energy and for a protracted period of time. He probably has no idea who or where he is now. Poor fellow. His voice doesn't even work. He is literally miles away from us. Someplace far away where no one's ever been. All alone.
Doctor!
That's bad.
Damn! That's evil!
Cloud.
Let us excuse ourselves.
Listen, would you all mind waiting outside?
Baron again, just like with Eris's death, looking out for his dude, genuinely caring.
What do you want me to do? Please, Cloud, talk to me. Tell me you see me, that you can hear me. Tell me, please. I came this far believing in the memories we had together. This isn't happening. This is too cruel. Oh, Cloud,
so what about him? You know, Cloud.
I'll say it again. He's got Mako poisoning. I've never seen a case this bad. An immense amount of Mako-drenched knowledge was put into his brain all at once. No normal human could have survived it. It's a miracle he did.
No wonder. After falling in the live stream and being washed up here.
But remember, the light of hope can be found anywhere. Listen, if you give up hope, what will happen to him?
Hope. Hey, but honestly, man, do I really want him to come back? What did he do for the world? What can he do for us from here on out? How many be nothing more than Sephiroth's shadow? He may be nothing more than Sephiroth's shadow.
There's something wrong?
No, nothing. Nothing at all, Doc. You okay?
Yes. I'm sorry I had you all worried. And I have something I want to tell you all. I don't care about anything else, only Cloud. I want to be by his side.
Yeah, that's probably best. For Cloud, and for you.
Yeah, right. Hey there, Tifa.
I'm sorry, everyone. At a time like this...
Why are you apologizing? We'll come back again, check on you.
Yeah, you hang in there, Tifa. Take care of Cloud, son.
Right.
Oh, and, Tifa, I don't like asking this, but is he really your childhood friend and not Sephiroth's shadow?
Huh? Well, that is... No, I'm sure of it.
Yeah. Okay, then. Sorry for asking that. We gotta go, we gotta get back to the High Wind.
Can't blame Barrett for asking that, but it's like... is Tifa just, Is Tifa coping? Is Tifa, like, burying her head in the sand, being delusional and denying, like, what Cloud is just because she doesn't want to accept it? You know, it's a legit thing. It's a rough thing to ask, you know, like, but yeah.
What are we gonna do now? What can we do? Huh? Ain't there nothing we can do? And don't go telling us to wait for Cloud to get better.
Oh, I've got some news.
Yeah, what? Was that you're a spy?
Yeah, I've already told you I was. Both.
Oh, okay, I get it.
Both.
And
up to something. Wanna eavesdrop?
Now then, we're faced with two issues. One, destroy Meteor. Two, remove the barrier around North Cave and defeat Severoth. Any ideas?
We already solved the first problem. A Meteor will soon be smashed to bits. The plan has already been put in motion, namely to collect huge materia from each region.
Well... huge materia is a high-density special type of materia made through a special compression process in Mako reactors. The energy extracted from it is 330 times the strength of normal materia. How about that? We will gather all the huge materia together and ram it into the meteor. That will cause a huge explosion, reducing meteor literally to bits. You're going to ram a meteor? Do you think we have the technology to do it? Don't worry about that. More importantly, we've got to collect huge materia from each area.
We've already collected materia from Nibelheim. All that's left is Corel and Fort Condor. I've already dispatched troops to Corel. Corel?
He's hometown.
What else can they do to Corel?
And the huge materia? You mean the huge materia, don't you? I've heard about it. When our small materia nears the larger one, something should happen. I'm certain of it. That's why we're using the power of materia in our fights.
Can't let She-Ra get a hold of the huge materia. Besides, when Cloud gets back, I want to show him this huge materia. He's gonna be shocked.
So, what are you saying, Barret? Even though you're always knocking him, you really want Cloud to return?
I ain't say nothing but nothing. You just shut your face. Every group's gotta have a leader. And that's me. Or at least I wanna be, but I ain't cut out to be no leader. I never knew that till lately. And that's what is.
What's going on, son?
You've been chosen to be the new leader.
Pain in the ass, son. Forget it. And that's the bottom line.
But for us to fight, we gotta have High Wind and you. We needed to save the planet. And who's running this ship? You! That's why you're our new leader. Ain't no one else can. The ship's gonna save the planet, huh? Ain't that gonna be just a little tough? Oh man, that went straight to my heart. I'm a man too, son. Okay, I'll do it. Everyone follow me, and that's the bottom line. Alright, now here's the first job. The operation room's waiting for you. Yeah! Hell yeah!
Still sloping a little bit, the camera there. Hopefully it won't drop. I don't think it's gonna drop, but, you know.
Yo, Sid! When you're ready, we're heading for the Corel reactor. Come on, Mr. Leader! You better hurry!
Like, fuck you!
I know you're all dying to talk to a babe like me. Just leave me alone. This ship makes me
bleh. Oh, hell, son. No one puke all over me.
So yeah, now Tifa is also gone.
See ya. Thank you for a job well done.
Well, Sid is a good leader choice because he's like an inspirational leader to his crew. He's been a community leader in his rocket town and all that stuff. So he's best cut out for it, especially since Barrett already like admits to himself that he's not cut out to be a leader. Man has grown, recognizes his own flaws, and I would think he kind of would have some sort of a personal limit of how many like fallen comrades under his command he can take, you know. And I'm gonna take Red. He's pretty far behind, but not too bad. Not too bad, like 4 levels. And yeah, getting a chance to use him again. So let's just before I assign the materia, I hope I get a chance to actually move the plane before we go to the reactor. I hope it's not gonna drop me there without me like assigning the materia, but I can always just pop up the menu. But I wanna go and buy latest equipment from the from Indonesia.
Yeah! Shall we take off?
Yes.
Woohoo! We're taking off!
Ease up on the crack there. Yes. Okay, we're here. Let's just go. Because I saw that there was a weapon shop, and I want to go sell a lot of the old weapons.
You hear the doggy. Poor doggy.
This. No mistaking. No mistaking about it. Oh, wait. There was a lady. Everybody's shop has like a chocobo thing going on, but I want to talk to the lady.
Hey, hey, hey! Gather round! This is a bargain! We've got the best armor and weapons, the likes of which you won't find anywhere else!
Damn, fed up!
But it's first come, first serve, so get yours now! Step right up! You there, don't just stand around outside. Go on in. Come on. Don't be shy. Step right up. I'll never know why he wanted to open a store in a dead town like this, but what's up with him? Sigh. You know something, Rudy? You're like school in summertime.
School in summertime?
Yeah, bitch. School in summertime. Open your fucking ears.
Welcome to the charity store, a store of love and courage. What can I get you today?
A bunch of jokers in this town, charity store, selling weapons. A crystal sword and crystal glove.
Ooh,
AM cannon. I have no idea what it's like, but it's a long-range weapon. The slots look fine. Crystal comb. Same thing here. It's a better weapon. And then, Partisan. Again, nice. Everybody's getting new weapons. Winchester. Again, I wish Vincent had limit breaks that were more to my liking. I'm not a big fan of the whole, like, dark and broody character trope, but, like, man, I'm a big Western fan, and, you know, him having Winchesters and Peacemakers and things like that, and also Stan Hansen's Lariato and all that. I just, you know, wizardry. Let's buy three of these. One for everybody. I'll arm everybody first, then I'll start selling. But thank you very much! Please come again. Let's do this. Here you go, Partisan. Crystal. Magic defense is lowered a little bit, but I don't care. Let's see. I have a lot of stuff I need to sell off of me. Crystal. Power is strength plus 10. Whoops. And then, yeah, there's, actually, let's be sure that I'm... Yeah, crystal comb was the thing. And then... Crystal bangle, gem ring, protects against paralyzed, petrified, slow. Automatically sets up reflect? No, that would be nice, but that also would work on healing stuff. I've kind of learned my lesson when I was fighting Genova. Vitality... Poison, protects against frog, small, confused berserk, nullifies cold attacks, drains water attacks, increases manipulation rate, protects against all abnormal status, dexterity plus 10. I'll take the ribbon. Alright, so now, let's start everything from scratch. I'll have at least two missions now where I'm going to be using this set of dudes, and that's gonna be like going to Barrett's hometown and then going to the Fort Condor. When I passed Fort Condor, I didn't even go there originally because I said that there's just a mini game inside and a doorman who even tells you that if you have something going on, you know, you can come back later. And now is the later because we're gonna be playing the same mini game when we go there, regardless. So okay, so let's start this. I'll make Red 13 my haste guy there, and both Barrett and Barrett and Sid are going to have restore all. I'm just doing it in this kind of order so that I stay on top of stuff. Store all. Now all the materials are there. Then I'm gonna have Barrett and Red have cover. There. I'm gonna have Sid have all the kind of, he's going to have the kind of cloud style stuff, meaning basically that he's going to have the luck, and he's going to have the, what was this, uses extra MP, yeah, this and Comet, I want that on him. Then I'm going to do the whole luck plus, and I want counterattack on him, there. Now, let's go through which, he's gonna have Odin
and he's going to have Odin, and let's give him Neo Bahamut there, and then let's give him, he has Comet, so let's give him Lightning and Fire. Out of all the music choices for this, this feels kind of fitting, but at the same time, it's kind of, you know. Let's give Barrett then. Let's give him Earth. Let's give him Poison. And let's give him. Lightning? Did I not give Lightning to? Did I give him something else? Like Ice? Well, let's give Lightning, Poison, Earth. What did I give Sid? Fire. Oh, yeah, that makes sense. let's give him Ice. So he has Ice, Fire, that's easy to remember, and Comet. Barrett has Earth, Poison, Lightning. And let's give him... He has to have Big Pig. I can't... Can't abide Barrett not having Big Pig. Let's give him also... let's give him enemy skill. Let's give him... Well, how about Titan? Big Pig, Titan, and then... You know, just to have, like, more elemental oomph there, let's just give him, well, Ramu. And now, let's go here. Okay. He has now, like, cover and the haste thing. He's going to have, well, I'll keep Ifrit around. But the important is for him to get Bahamut and Leviathan. Those are still pretty good. Fire... What else is there in terms of, like, just regular-ass attack spells? Sorry that this takes such a long time. Oh, he'll have enemy skill. That's useful. Oh, man, am I running out of stuff? I don't want to give him any of the stuff that the others had. So let's just have him have Shiva as well. Well, take Deathblow. And Steel is gonna up his dexterity. Did I have another Steel? Yeah, his dexterity is gonna be upped pretty well. I don't want the gravity thing. Well, I'm kind of lying, I do. I'm gonna exchange one of the Steels to the, to gravity. It's the one that takes, like, a percentage out of your enemy. I'm not really hot about it, and I also haven't gotten it upgraded because I'm not very hot about it. Okay, now, finally, let's sell some weapons! get into this. Alright, let's see. Butterfly Edge, Murasame, Platinum Fist, Chainsaw, Rocket Punch, Hairpin, Mithril Rod, Wiser Staff,
Spear,
Javelin, Twin Viper, Silver M-Phone, Silver Rifle, Silver Armlet, I don't want to get rid of Ending Code because it has so many slots in that life, and I don't want to get rid of those rings. I'll just hold on to some of those. Dragonlance was great. It, like, micro laser, the plasma weapon. Hopefully I won't regret this. Hopefully when it comes time for me to, like, again go through, like, my roster and change up the guys around. Kaiser Knuckle, you know. Goodbye, Nail Bat. You won't be missed. that I'll get a chance to go and let's sell some materia as well. Let's sell that. Let's sell that. Let's sell that. No thanks. Steel, I'll keep it because it gives added. I'm holding on to the MP absorb stuff because even though I haven't seen it do anything, I feel like that's because I'm dumb and I don't see it. But I even looked it up online and it said, like, combine it with something and it really, like, it does what it does, you know, but I haven't just... There's been no, like, pop-up text of, like, ooh, added damage or something. Throw, I'll keep that. Chocobo Lure, I'll keep that. Revive, Chocobo Mocha, I don't want to sell any of my summons. They are too sentimental. Transform, no thanks. Manipulate, no thanks. Sense, I don't really care about this, really. I'll keep it, but... Confuse, no thanks. That's pretty much it. Frinery! Thank you very much! Please come again. That music, I'm like... Wow, my brains are like oozing out of my nostrils now due to listening to that. And just because of that, I don't want to enter into a lot of buildings, but hey, old man!
Everything must come to an end, and someday it's gonna be your turn. Even the world's gonna end sometime. Everybody leaves at one time or another, and everyone gets left also. That's just fate. It's sad, but there's nothing that can be done about it, so that's why I'm praying like this for all of you. Ancient weapon? End of the world? I don't know nothing about that. I'm gonna live to be 100. There's tons of stuff still I still gotta do. That's just the beginning. And what? Heave, Shinra and Soldier.
Is that an accent?
And what? Heave, Shinra and Soldier done about it? Tell me, they're a waste. What have they done?
Actually, I'm a beautiful maid. I just work here in the accessory store part time. Everything here can compare with the best goods anywhere. So how about one?
What? You're selling me like toast? Oh, wow!
Ooh, thank you. I'll gladly
buy 3 of those.
Thank you, stop by again.
She sold me, 3, like, luck rings. What was it called? Luck plus 10, amulet. Yes, I want more luck. It's like, that's one of my, like, biggest, like, if there was more luck plus materia, I'd, like, hog that stuff. I love consistently doing more damage and getting, like, critical hits and not missing.
You say you don't know when the stars are gonna fall out of the sky? Is that for real? I still don't believe it. How could this be happening?
Just because you don't understand it don't mean it ain't happening, goddammit.
Alright, I think we've had enough of this town. Except I want to talk to this person.
Never seen you here before. You from out of town? How are things on the outside? Between the earthquakes and meteor, it just might be the end of the world, like everyone's been saying. Oh, how depressed. What a miserable world this is!
Well, you get a whole slew of like a rainbow of different kinds of attitudes in this town. Some people have accepted that the world's coming to an end. Some people are burying their heads in the sand, and
And some people are just shocked and all that about it. Just making sure that camera isn't sloping too bad. But yeah, we're going to Barrett's hometown, to North Correll. It's the place here in the mountains, north of, there's the prison, but here's where we're going. Here's where we're going. All right. Now I feel like everything is fine, and because there was such a long kind of story development thing and all that, and all sorts of, like, managing the slots and everything like that, I just feel like I want to save, just because if something happens, if all of a sudden, like, electricity goes out or something like that, that's a lot of stuff to go through, you know? Familiar place. I'm not heading to the gold saucer. Instead, we're heading to the reactor. Yeah, is it gonna be one of those self-destroying fireball things? I remember seeing a lot of those in these parts. Yes, it is! Well, let's see how our new weapons look. Let's just attack it. I'm sure it's gonna die from just a couple of hits. There you go. Well, the sad thing about, nice-looking weapons. The sad thing about Red's weapons is that you don't really see them on him. I don't know if his character model actually, like, changes, like, any of the feathers or anything like that that he has on. But it's not, at least, it's not very obvious when you arm him with a new weapon. I'm liking what Sid is holding. It looks like a glaive. Looks like a glaive or some sort of a, big spear. Glaives are pretty much like my, there's sometimes the terminology is like kind of muddled, and sometimes glaive means one thing and sometimes another. I've seen people basically like label those kind of two-handed, really long, like, swords, the sort of swords that... Oh, I see. It has, like, those spikes to the side, so it's a boar spear. It's a boar spear. Those spears were specifically designed with the prongs or the spikes to the side, so that if you're trying to spear a boar, and it doesn't care about the pain and is still coming onward to gore you, those will stop it, like, going just through the spear and right into you, So that's neat. But yeah, I really like pole arms and stuff, and I think, like, right now I have, like, a thing for, like, these faux shards, these glaives or, like, these spears. I consider a glaive to be like a spear that's basically like on top of a pole. You have basically a giant butcher's knife style tip, That's in my mind a glaive, but can't be sure because some people have, like I said, used the term to describe those kind of swords like in the opening of Lord of the Rings, what the High Elves have when they do the coordinated slash thing against the orcs, I can't be sure, but I think a glaive with a full shard is a spear where the tip looks like a giant kitchen knife, basically, and on the kind of back end of it that's not sharp, there's like a prong that pokes like kind of upwards in an angle so that you can catch blades with it, and if you work in like a pair with two people with those kind of faux shards, you're like one person can focus more on like grabbing the opponent's blade and redirecting it and binding it, and the other can then just go ahead and stab. Oh, again, like a big shotgun style kaboom on Barrett. It's pretty similar looking to the micro laser. It just has like more
expressive, like, protrusions, like those flaps on the side and stuff. They just stand out more.
You guys are...
Hell yeah, time to fight. Goddamn Shinra soldiers.
Let's just do these regular ass attacks. We'll see if they're tougher or anything. Damn, do I need to slap Red to get him awake? Most likely no, because that guy most likely is just one hit away from doing it. Even so, most likely he'd shoot at them, and that would wake them up as well. Yeah, it's starting to get kind of like tricky at this point. You know, if somebody falls asleep and you do such crazy damage that...
Guess we're safer now!
Oh!
Damn! It's the A-Train! It's the A-Train!
We're just watching. There it goes.
Looks like they're taking off with a huge materia in that train, son! No! You damn boneheads!
Did the Shinra beat us?
Hey! Do you know who I am? I'm Sid! That's who the hell I am! Now just let me handle it! Yeah, that's the bottom line! Cause Sid said so! Hey, 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 hey!
Yeah, I'm a pilot. I can pilot, like, airships, space rockets, tiny Broncos, and trains, and whatever.
They call me Mr. Noboreko.
That's one of the things that when I was a teenager, I used to watch this anime.
How can they even drive this? Don't ask me, I don't know. What? Don't worry, I can handle this kind of stuff. Two levers, one for the right and one for the left, son. I see. I just alternate the two levers up and down, right? Judging from the enemy speed, I'd say I'd take about 10 minutes, son. We're gonna fly. Hold on tight.
Left lever, directional button up. Right lever, triangle.
Pum, 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 pum.
Oh, man. It's... These things are... Oh, oh, fuck, fuck. These, like, rhythm things are always, like, they're about you not screwing up the rhythm so that it takes time for you to recover. Pump, 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 pump away. Pump, 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 pump. Oh, fuck, 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 fuck,
fuck. All right, we're gonna jump, son.
That's how it works, and not like, you just, oh well, the timer is going, let's not goof around now. Yeah, it's going all during the battle as well, let's not goof around at all, let's just see if we can kill him with everybody just thinking. Oh, I should use haste, that's like a major thing, I need to use haste, because we're in a hurry. But then again, he did the whole, I think it's the confuse thing. Yeah, it makes it so that I can't use materia anyway. There you go. Great. Yeah, 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 yeah. Thankfully, timer isn't running while I'm looking at those. Okay, I'm encountering an enemy on each one of the carts. Oh, two. Hopefully, let's just try and get... Yes! Let's just keep on punching them, but as long as Red gets to, yes, do the haste, I think good.
No! Motherfucker, it nullified it. I have all the luck stuff. I have all the luck stuff, and you guys are still missing like crazy. Come on now. Come on now. It's been a little while since I had like a grinding session, so I might be like a little bit behind. Man. You guys are losing precious time here. But I'm still gonna, if those enemies keep coming, oh, this is something new, I'm still gonna cast haste. Yes. How do you like fire? How do you like electricity? Fire again. Ice. Quake. I have no idea how much he has health, so let's not dilly-dally around anything. Let's just gotta nuke the bastard. So much damage. Well, I mean, I think his whole point of existing is to just hold me. There you go. Nice. Still have 6.5 minutes. Come on. As long as it's something like that, like a... Okay, I think this is basically like a boss. Let's bring out big guns. Big pig. Although I don't know if he's gonna care about big pigs like Stomp because he's in the air. Oh yeah, I shouldn't have done this, man. The clock running there, it's like a clear indicator of like, what are you doing, man? But then again, look at the damage. Maybe it's worth it. The very next thing I'm gonna do is cast haste again and just try and compensate for the amount of time this shit is taking, but... Let's just say that after I've done these three big summons, there's no way I have time to do any more summons against this guy. So, let's just keep. Yeah, I was just, I cut myself off. I constantly do that. I cut myself off when I get distracted or the game moves onward. But I was talking about the anime I used to watch as a teenager. It was called Get Backers. And it was like this kind of a X-Men style setting of characters having like mutant style powers and, you know, being kind of mercenaries or hired guns or whatnot. And it followed like these two characters who had like this kind of a business together, kind of like having a like a private detective kind of an office thing, but for those sorts of mercenary jobs and whatnot. And, 7,900! And I just remember that in that show, in the very early parts of it, they were doing a gig, and they had, like, a group of enemies that were also like hired guns and stuff, and they were
They all had their own set of powers, but one of them was like, he didn't have magic powers or like mutant powers, but he had the equivalent, kind of like if you stat Marvel characters, some characters don't have superpowers, but they're just as formidable, and so their like natural powers are like really pushed up.
What the? You guys? All right, just hand over the huge materia. Shit! Whoa!
What, like back fist? Okay, let's nuke this guy as well. But yeah, the guy who didn't have superpowers, his thing was that he was like the world's greatest driver, and he was driving like a semi truck through the mission, and his thing was that he could drive a semi truck on the level of being like a supernaturally powered kind of a person, so he was like really sliding on, I guess, walls and doing all sorts of crazy stunt work.
You got guts coming after me? I'll never forget you! Got no time for that now!
We got it going, but what about the brakes?
I know already! Just shut up and keep quiet! If we keep this up, we'll crash right into North Korea, son! Let's see if we alternately use the levers to accelerate. It should break if we move the levers up and down simultaneously.
Left lever up, directional button down, right lever up. Okay, so... Yeah, come on. Why isn't anything happening?
Hey, it's not working!
We're gaining speed.
Why isn't he doing it? Okay.
Motherfucker, the other way! Just watch this time, Al!
Oh, fuck. Do I need to, like... What? Do I need to tap?
Hey! Hey!
Whoa!
What is going on?
Shit!
It's 2 minutes left, so I'm guessing I did it. Did. That was, like, tough because I was expecting that it was gonna be another one of those, but he did nothing, so I, like, left guessing, am I supposed to tap? Received key item, huge materia. Yeah, remember back in the ruins of, what was it, Gongaga? You know, the town that was named by a toddler? You know, like... The town name that means you made boom boom in your diaper. Gongaga. But yeah, there, you know, you hid in the ruins of the reactor and Scarlet and Zen came by looking for huge materia. So that's... What? Oh, yeah, I really don't like the look of these, like having the finger pointing where your character is and having the little triangles showing like where...
You guys are really something.
You sure are brave. I'm impressed.
I'm really glad that Barrett is with me for this sort of praise. Yeah.
Aren't you the ones that stopped the Shinra train? The Shinra was just about to destroy our lives again.
It might be full of junk, but this is the only home we got.
Barrett?
Oh, of course. We're all born and raised in the coal mines. No matter how tough it gets, our hearts burn bright and red like coal.
To hell with Meteor. We're coal miners, aren't we? We'll dig a deep tunnel and hide from the Meteor.
That's it. Hey, kid, how about giving something to these guys fighting the Shinra?
Gonna get.
I got it out of the well. Isn't it amazing? Isn't it an amazing rock?
Received Ultima.
Must have been a horrific battle. You have scars all over your body. I already talked to the inn's owner today. You can rest for free.
Well, thanks. I didn't even remember that there was an inn. Oh, thanks. What was the ultima? Was it like a... Oh, yeah, I remember this. Okay, let's see. What is ultima? Okay, so it must be a materia. Let's see. Ultima. Equips Ultima magic ability Ultima. I'm guessing that it's some sort of an attack. Red can have it instead of steel because he already is like short on attack spells. Alright. Oh, okay.
Please come again.
All right. Now we have this huge materia. Next stop is going to be Fort Condor. Oh, this way, yeah.
Back to our plane.
Here we go. And I think everything is fine. I don't need to really go and fiddle around with anything. Everything's fine. Damn Junon. Okay. Here. Right? There it is, yeah.
There's the phoenix.
Or is it the rock? Bird. But yeah, like the,
Here we go. Captain Shin is on the job, son.
We've been fighting the Shinra for a long time at this battlefield. Even now, we're still settled in for a long war with them. If you aren't in a hurry, would you help us fight them? Listen, I don't want to push, but if you got something else to do, why don't you finish that first?
Like to help, but I guess we'll help you.
I have a little bit of a sneaking suspicion because this seems like they're not saying like, oh, the Shinra is attacking!
Alright then, take care of yourselves.
I'll just to be sure, I'll talk to everybody on the deck of the ship because if there needs to be like, if there needs to be like a trigger, if there needs to be basically like a character saying that, hey, okay, that's it. Next stop, Fort Condor.
What's next? Shall we head for Fort Condor?
Just like I said.
I guess so, son.
We'll do our best for Cloud and you, and Ares too.
Hell yeah!
Don't expect anything else from me except fighting besides you. I don't have any comforting words. Of course, I don't believe you're the type of guy who needs kindness from others.
Fuck you!
Ah, so brooding ya.
The huge materials at Corel, Fort Condor. I'm sure there was another place like that had it. Where was that?
We'll get to that once we're done with this.
Huh? Mr. Leader, what's next?
Alright, now...
Yoo-hoo! Shall we take off?
It's a maniac! Why do you bite me?
Wouldn't surprise me if the driver in training would bite somebody. He's saying the same thing, but...
Well, if you're not in a hurry,
okay, I...
Really? Then go up, and they'll fill you in all the details.
Okay. But yeah, I need to, this is a mini game, and it's a mini game I'm not fond of, mostly because it just... It's very slow and takes time and stuff. The mini games in this game aren't really all that much to my liking for the most part, and this is one of them. Thankfully, there's an out, because the thing is that enemies are going to advance up a hill, and I need to set up defenses, and then we'll just play out this slow battle of me trying to keep them from getting up. But if they do get up, all I need to do is just battle them in this typical Final Fantasy combat style, so that's much more appealing. So instead of setting up any defenses, I'm just gonna let them come up. It's gonna take a while, but once they come up, I can just
kick their ass.
Now this is something I never thought anyone would ever climb up here. Any minute now, this will be a battlefield against Shinra. You'd better get down before you get involved.
No, I am here to get involved.
A battlefield? We can't overlook that.
Shinra, the hell are those jackasses doing here?
Shinra again?
It appears you have a problem with Shinra too. After all, you climbed up here. Why not listen to what I have to say for a moment?
Alright, talk on, son!
Do you know what's at the top of this mountain?
Something's up there?
No matter how you look at it, that's a reactor. And on top of it, is that the condor?
I can see you're very perceptive. Yes, it's a reactor and a condor. Looks like there's a special materia up in the Mako reactor. Then came the Condor, so Shinra dispatched the troops to get rid of it. Their plan is to get rid of the Condor and the people on this mountain and to get the materia from the Mako reactor. Unfortunately, we don't have the ability to fight Shinra ourselves. That's why we have hired soldiers to help us. As our sponsor, you can help us with a contribution or fighting alongside of us. What do you think? You want to join us in our fight?
If you go that far, what can I say? Well, we'll be able to do something if you leave it up to us.
Hey, we'll come to the rescue.
Got it. I'm gonna lend a hand too.
All right. But the way he's talking, it makes it seem like... this is just the regular... Oh, okay, this just leads to a store. I'm not looking to go buy anything there because I'm guessing the stuff they have for sale is the same stuff they would have when it first was possible to come here, you know. The merchandise doesn't upgrade with the passage of the game, I don't think. But yeah, it still feels like... it's not like the big... story thing right now, but then again, I have Cid with me, so it must be.
So shall I let you in on our strategy? The enemy is targeting the mountain's reactor and will be climbing to reach it. We must set a trap and hire soldiers to protect the place. Well, this is all we have. This village doesn't have any money. Even if we wanted to fight, our hands are tied, 'cause we're broke. To hire one soldier, we need 400 gil. So if we hire 20 soldiers, we must have 8,000 gil.
That is, we would like to use your own money. We would like you to use your own money to hire these soldiers, but buy the trap, set it up, and give the commands. We know that we're asking. We know that what we're asking is selfish. We send our wives and kids to another village. We are resigned to our fate. Let's get to square one. If the enemy penetrates this shed, you'll have to fight them off immediately. I know it's a one-shot deal, but I'm asking for your help. Now then, is there anything you wish to ask?
Conditions for victory, the enemy soldiers, which can be hired, about funding, other issues.
Enough!
Because I'm not planning on doing any of that.
Ready?
Okay, ready.
This is the deciding battle. The enemy numbers more than ever before.
Yeah.
Is it loading?
Yeah. All right. That's neat looking. Now the condor. Yeah, it's like the egg is like the dome on that. That's where we are in the shack. But yeah. Enemies are gonna be coming from here. Set units. Start the game. Yes. Speed high, low.
Ooh,
can I? Yes, I can raise the speed. Good. Come out as fast as possible because you know they're coming this slowly and they have to make it all the way up to this shack. And I'll fight them the regular fashion. I'm not gonna be putting any resistance here. So yeah, this is gonna take a while. But I figured I might use this time a little bit to talk about Final Fantasy and my kind of perspective on it. I've said it before a couple of times that my favorite Final Fantasy games are 6, 7, and 9. And for me, it's like a very simple thing of those games basically like have such high quality in terms of their stories, worlds, characters, and soundtracks and all that, that they just rise above for me personally, but for different reasons. 6, I love the art design and the look of 6. 6 is like the prettiest looking game out of all of them for me. I love that sort of pixel graphic thing and its choice of colors and designs on a lot of things. It's just, it's just perfect. 7 is, you know, it's fantastic, but I have a lot of nostalgia goggles going on when it comes to 7. But yeah, I still love it a lot. And 9, for my money, 9 is the best story and best character drama. And I also really like its art style. When I was a teenager, when it came out, I really rejected its art style. It was just like you know, I wanted something edgy and serious and all those kinds of things, and its kind of child-friendly look wasn't for me, you know? And I kind of just slept on it. I only played it for the first time only like 4 years ago, and I immediately fell in love with it. I think it has like the best villain. I think it has the best kind of like villain protagonist kind of story, and it has, to my mind,
enemy invasion.
It has the best party of main characters.
My God, they're attacking! We're counting on you.
It has the best kind of where everyone in the party feels like they align with each other to where they support each other's, like, let's just nuke this guy because I can't be sure how tough he is. Yeah. And it's just basically, I love the story of it. A lot of those three games have super similar things going on. A lot of, without spoiling, there's a lot of thought put into this kind of like artificial, kind of synthetic human idea.
and the kind of individuality and the kind of like legitimacy of someone who was like made yesterday, or like kind of the same way as Cloud is, you know, has been talked about like he's just a puppet that was created by Hojo and stuff. The same sort of themes of like of that sort of thing, like, okay, if your memories and experiences determine greatly who you are as a person and your personality and your all that stuff, if that was like created in a lab or created artificially, is that like in any way less legitimate than someone who's actually lived a full life or something? I really love that stuff, and I think many of these favorites that I have, those three games, dive into those things. They also dive into this kind of industry versus nature, this kind of man's kind of influence on our surroundings, and a lot of these kind of themes of like protecting nature and wildlife and sanctity of those things, and industry kind of like, you know, killing it, you know, and also like all kinds of stuff like that, and they also have a lot of this kind of like magical ancient civilizations that had a more harmonious relationship with nature, and then kind of the modern world coming in like a bulldozer to just like wreck it, so that there's like the ancient people and the modern people and their conflict with one another.
Yes, we did it! That was wonderful! Thank you! I doubt Shinra will attack now!
Bird. Yeah, but that's the phoenix for you.
That light just now! The condor! The eggs! What? Would you go outside and see what it was?
Just in case it's radioactive.
A widow bug.
Phoenix materia.
What about the huge materia, man? Did I need to pick it up somehow?
No, I don't think. I think that it was only the Phoenix thing. Or does he say anything else? Or like, come on, like let's just be sure.
No, it's just talking to him is looking out the window, yeah.
All right, let's go talk to the guy who was, like, by the table, who told us all about this stuff.
Oh, yeah, I gave him a woman's voice. I can't be sure if it's a woman.
Everyone, thanks! I really mean it, thanks. Although there isn't anything we can give you, we'll...
They told us that all the women and children are out of the town, so maybe he's just high-pitched.
We'll make sure you can stop in and stay anytime, so be sure to drop by. Yes, yes, and there's one thing I forgot to tell you.
Yeah, received key items, huge materia.
Huh? What's this, son? Damn, man, it's huge materia.
The truth is, this is the materia inside the reactor.
What the hell did we fight for?
We weren't protecting the reactor, we were protecting the condors. When that reactor was built, they forced us to help. That's how we knew what was inside the reactor. I knew this day would come, so after the Shinra left, I sneaked in and took the materia. I didn't mean to fool you, but I guess that's how it ended up. I'm really sorry.
Just forget about it, son. Anyway, we're still alive.
I see. If you put it that way, we're really grateful.
So the last huge materia that Shinra's after's in the underwater reactor in Junon? We gotta get the first and beat them no matter what. But you know, Shinra's probably on high alert since we always mess with him. How about we take a break and go see that little fella for a bit? You must mean Cloud. Oh, hell yeah! I'm worried about Tifa. She may have collapsed taking care of the guy. How about checking on him down in Medeal?
Hell yeah. That's our next set of business right there. So, but yeah, I just want to mention that what I was saying about Final Fantasy games, 6, 7, and 9 are my favorites, but then there's things like, I've never played Final Fantasy 8. I just basically like brushed it off because I'm not into the sort of high school, teenage anime stuff, but then again, the people who love the game are like, you know, that's just the opening first part of the game, so don't judge it based on that. And I'm like, okay, I'm open to the idea, I just never have gotten around to it. Like I said, I played Final Fantasy IX only like 4 years ago, so 8 is something that's a conquest for another day, maybe someday. But then there's games like Final Fantasy X and Final Fantasy IV that are games that I really wish I would like more than I do. It's like Final Fantasy IV, I really like the story of it, the characters of it, but I've said before in some other video or some other play session that in Final Fantasy VI, one of the things that holds it back for me a little bit is how much the game splits the party and then splits the narrative of the story in like, okay, let's follow these few guys, and when we are done, meanwhile, you follow these guys, and then again, like, meanwhile, you know, and you don't get to like pick your set of dudes for your party all that much. And even though I love 6, it's still something that in my eyes kind of, you know, holds it back a little bit. And in 4, if I remember correctly, they do that a lot more, to the point where I don't even know who's the main character in Final Fantasy IV, really. Like, it starts with somebody being the main character, but it just jumps around all the time, and I hate the villain in that game. It's, like, one of the cheapest, laziest villain ideas ever. It's basically like, somebody is a villain, you beat them up, and they say, oh, I was under some sort of mind control, now I'm your friend. And then somebody else shows up and is like, I'm the villain now. Then you beat them up, and they're like, oh, I was under mind control, I'm your friend now. And then you do that enough times until you come up to, you know, the thing, the entity that's just kind of like an elemental force without a personality and these sort of things, if I remember correctly, but I remember being just really frustrated with the villains of that game. And with Final Fantasy X, I love the game mechanic of it. It feels wonderful to play that game. I love it. But its main character is a spawn from hell.
I can't even remember his name right now, but the blonde blitzball superstar character, he's basically like, if I could gaze into the mouth of hell, I would see his face going, ha, 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 you know, I can't stand the fucker. And it's like Yuna seems like such a nice character, because I've been watching other people play Final Fantasy X. Yuna seems like such a nice character, and it's really her story, you know, in a lot of ways. I wish I could have, like, just Yuna be the main character, and not that Hellspawn, and I'm not that big into the villain, the veins, and the whole sin thing. I'm not really into that. And also, it's the first voice-acted Final Fantasy, and it takes a lot of it away for me. It's just not my cup of tea. I wish it was, but then the next one was like 10-2, and it focused on just about everything I didn't like about the aesthetic and the world and stuff like that about Final Fantasy X and about some other Final Fantasy games, and I was just like, I'm checking out. And then when I came back to look like, well, where's Final Fantasy these days? Oh, there's a Final Fantasy that everybody's shitting on because it's such like a corridor running like thing. I think it's Final Fantasy 13, maybe? Something like that. The one where there's a guy who has a bird living in his afro, and everybody hates that game. Everybody talks shit about that. And I was like, okay, I'm not getting into that. And then like, what's next? Oh, an MMO. I'm like, I'm done. You know, I'm done with Final Fantasy. I want to play 8 someday. I want to get acquainted with that. And, Bloodfang. And I just want to replay some of my favorites, but... Ooh, these are pretty tough. Oh, I wasn't paying attention.
Satellite beam.
Most likely, the other one would have done more damage, but let's see if they all die. Ah, there you go. How about the XP? Oh, nice! You get quite a bit of XP. This might be a good spot to grind when it comes time to, grind before the end game. But yeah, I'm gonna take this opportunity to go and have a refill of coffee, and I'll be back in a sec. Boom! And I'm back. Let's go and see what Cloud and Tifa are up to.
Damn, son! Open a can of whoop ass!
It's no use. I don't understand a thing, Cloud. What should I do? What if you never recover for the rest of your life? Ah!
What did you say, Cloud? Damn! What the hell's going on?
Well, they said there's quakes. Now, this is a hot springs kind of place. I would guess that there's a lot of, like...
What's this? The live stream is gushing up from below the surface of the Earth, son! Damn! That is bad!
Sid, what's wrong?
Nothing! You and Cloud get inside quick, son! And that's the bottom line!
But I
said that's the bottom line. Hey, don't worry about a thing. I ain't about to die that easily.
Be careful.
Okay, here I go. Watch this. Get that piece of trash out of my ring. Damn, that motherfucker whipping. Of all the times to show up. Okay then, come on, you pussy piece of shit!
That's what he is. He's a pussy piece of shit. That I remember, he's called Ultima. Ultima Weapon. He's the type of weapon that you fight, and when he's had enough, he escapes. Oh shit. Regen on everybody. Haste on everybody. Cure 3 on everybody. Damn! Oh my god. That's pretty rough, but thankfully I did. I did the right things, I think. There. Haste. Sip. Hyper jump. Let's see if Red can slow it down. I don't know if he can. He can't stop it. That's something I learned. The stop won't work on bosses. And even then, if you stop somebody, if you strike them, they get out of the stop. And slow. Maybe I can slow. Ooh. Yeah, just keep on spamming that cure. Ramu Titan. Kyata. Let's see that. Let's save up that for a bit. Bahamut. Damn, this is the toughest fight thus far in terms of the damage. But yeah. This is a clear indicator that I'm on a spot where I should grind some more. Get some levels on my guys, but it's also, you know, Big Pig! Big Pig is bigger than a freaking Ultima weapon. Yeah, it slowed. Fantastic. Neo Bahamut. Ooh, that's pretty tough. Okay. Cure 3 on everybody. Just wonder what's gonna happen once I start to run out of MP, because that's starting to get to be a really, like, serious possibility for the near future. But then again, I'm also doing pretty good damage, and I have the haste and the slow going for me. Giga Flare. I don't remember what Stardust Ray does, but Blood Fang is good, and especially against a single opponent like this. Yeah. Dragon against Kaiju, or I guess dragons are Kaijus in this kind of setting. Yeah. When it comes to Kaiju stuff, I'm really like... there's stuff I have a lot of nostalgia for. I have a ton of nostalgia for the Heisei era Godzilla movies, you know, from the 90s, and I think Godzilla versus King Ghidorah is my favorite Godzilla movie, like in that kind of sense, where if you're looking for Ooh, let's try out Common now. What? Oh! There it went. Okay, well, he took me to a scary place. He didn't, like, kill anybody, and I didn't run out of MP, so... Oh, I didn't get any XP because he ran away. Yeah. He's gonna be somebody who's gonna be roaming in the map And he's gonna be like, when you wind up killing him, you'll get Cloud's best sword.
You motherfucker! You trying to escape?
Yeah, he knows I would have kicked its ass. No, I wouldn't have. But it's like, once I've grinded enough to feel secure about going to the end game of the game, I'm gonna seek that guy out and I'm gonna kill it to get Cloud's best sword.
Damn, man! Just a little bit more and would have smashed him.
It looks like the live stream has settled as well.
Don't talk too soon.
Damn! You gotta be kidding, son! This is bad! The main stream is kicking up! Something way bigger than that last one is on its way! No good! Get out of here, son!
But what about Tifa and Cloud?
God damn it, son! You don't have time to worry about anyone other than yourself! You don't know where that stream's below! Whoa! There's no time! Hurry, son! And that's the bottom line! Tifa, Cloud, get out of here!
This is bad! The tremors are getting worse! Wait a minute, Cloud! Doctor, shouldn't we move him somewhere rather than stay here?
Oh, he was just daydreaming while tremors are going.
It might be safer to take refuge in a wide open space.
Don't you worry about a thing, Cloud. I'll see to it that you get somewhere safe.
No, the structure can't take it. Hurry!
Yes! Ready, Cloud? We're leaving now!
Yay, again these cutscenes. Little chibis running.
No!
An entire village. An entire culture. Entire history. Maybe even an entire language. Extinguished in a heartbeat. Right into the live stream you go. Swirling, swirling.
Where am I? What's happening? Where's Cloud? Cloud, where are you? Huh? What? Who?
It's like machine gun fire and radio sounds or something.
Who is it? I can't hear!
Laughing? Sounds like the laugh from Final Fantasy VI's main villain, Kefka.
Wait a minute! I don't know anything about that! No, it's not me! I'd never do anything like that! No, stop it! Stay back! Somebody help! Please! Cloud, help me!
Listening to the Tetsuo the Iron Man soundtrack.
Ah! my. Cloud? What is it, Cloud? What is this? Is this the inside of your dreams? Or is it your subconsciousness? You're searching, aren't you, Cloud? Searching for yourself. I can help too. We'll work together to try and get the real you back. But where do we start?
There's the well.
That starry night at the well? The promise we made that night? What if that memory was all a lie?
Oh, I think that's Cloud saying,
that starry night at the well, the promise we made that night, what if that memory was all a lie? A sealed up secret, wish, tender feelings, that no one can ever know. The gates of Nibelheim. 5 years ago, Sephiroth passed through these gates. And that's how it all started.
It connects to Nibelheim. That's right. It's probably best to start from there. Let's go have a look, Cloud. I know it's not easy, but I'll be right with you. Cloud, look! Here's the well. And that's Gramps Inn, too. The only truck in town. It's been here since we were little kids, right? This is the Nibelheim you remember, right? It's the same as my Nibelheim. That's why this place is our Nibelheim. Years ago, two men from Soldier came. Sephiroth and a young and vibrant soldier. Can you tell me again what happened?
How does it feel?
5 years ago, I saw the real Sephiroth for the very first time.
It's your first time back to your hometown in a long time, right? So, how does it feel? I would know, because I don't have a hometown.
How about your parents?
So this is the great Sephiroth.
My mother is Genova. She died right after she gave birth to me. My father...
But to tell you the truth, I thought he was very cold.
What does it matter? All right, let's go.
I remember, I felt a foreboding about him. No, Cloud. I've been hiding it for some time, afraid that I would, if I told you, something terrible might happen. But
I'm not going to hide anything anymore. You weren't there. Cloud did not come to Nibelheim 5 years ago. I waited, but Cloud never came. The two that were ordered here were Sephiroth and another person.
All right, let's go. Soldier who came with Sephiroth wasn't Cloud?
There's nothing I can say. You must find the answer yourself. If you can't, then you... Take your time, Cloud. Slowly, little by little, okay?
Here, but let's check. No, he rises up.
That starry night at the well, and our promise that night. What if the memory was just a lie?
Oh. Don't hurry, Cloud. Don't answer too quickly. Just keep checking all those small emotions, and it'll come back. Slowly, little by little. Right, like that star, like the sky that night, the heavens were filled with stars. From the beginning, okay? Try and remember, Cloud. Right, I was wearing these clothes. That's you, too. You were so small then. And cute. Sephiroth once said, Cloud made up his memories by listening to my stories. Did you imagine this sky? No, do you remember it? That night the stars were gorgeous. It was just Cloud and I. We talked at the well. That's why I continued to believe that you were the real Cloud. I still believe you're the Cloud from Nibelheim. But you don't believe in yourself. These memories aren't enough. Cloud, what about your other memories? No, not memories. A memory is something that has to be consciously recalled, right? That's why sometimes it can be mistaken and a different thing. But it's different from a memory locked deep within your heart. That's why it must be a fake. If he could recall up that memory... That's it. What about some memory that has to do with me? I say something and you don't remember it. But you say something and I remember it too. Then we'll know that's our memory. Talk to me about anything, some important memory to you. Now that you mention it, why did you want to join Soldier in the first place? I always thought it was a sudden decision you made.
I was
devastated. I wanted...
I was devastated. I wanted to be noticed.
Oh, I was devastated. I wanted to be noticed. I thought if I got stronger, I could get someone to notice.
Someone to notice you? Who?
Who? You know who. You. That's who. You.
Me? Why?
Tifa, did you forget about those days?
Look, I'm sorry, but what are you talking about? No, it's all right. You were having a hard... No,
it's all right. You were having a hard time back then. You were so busy with your own things. It's only natural you don't remember me back then.
Back then?
It's important to me. I hate to say it, but it's a very important memory. Do you want to see it? Come on, hurry. A sealed up secret. Wish. Tender memories. No one can ever know. Do you know where this window goes to, Tifa? Fine, I'll go.
Tifa's house from Nibelheim.
My room?
It was my first time there.
Was it?
I only used to look up at it from outside.
Hey, look!
Can't be sure always who's talking.
Cloud's coming!
Who are your kids?
Do you think he wants to come in? Was that the first day you came into my room? That's right. We live next to each other. But I really didn't know you that well. I've known you since we were children and always thought we were close. Now that you mention it, I don't recall you ever being in my room.
Tifa always used to be with this threesome.
That's right.
I used to think they were all stupid.
What?
You were all childish, laughing at every little stupid thing.
But we were children back then.
I know. I'm the one that was stupid. I really wanted to play with everyone, but I was never allowed into the group. Then, later, I began to think I was different. That I was different from those immature kids. That then, maybe.
Just maybe. They would invite me in. was so prejudiced and weak. That night, I called Tifa out to the well. I thought to myself, Tifa would never come, that she hated me.
Yeah, it was so sudden, I was a bit surprised. But it's true that we weren't that close, but after you left town, I really thought about you a lot. I used to wonder how Cloud was doing. I wonder if Cloud was able to get into Soldier. I started reading the newspapers, thinking that there might be an article about you.
Thanks, Tifa. Tell him what you told me later. He'll probably be so happy.
Maybe I should use a kid's voice, but I'm not gonna change it now.
Okay.
This is all like ethereal, kind of like strange stuff anyhow. And he's in anguish, so...
Huh? What happened on this day? Was it a special day?
This was the day. Tifa's mother.
The day Mom died? I want to see Mom! I wonder if there's anything beyond that mountain. Mount Nebel is scary. Many people have died there. No one crosses that mountain alive. How about those that died? Did Mama pass through the mountains? I'm going!
It's really getting to me.
One of the kids turns back.
Sort of stuff when you grow older, little kids going through tragedies and things like that, it really like breaks your heart, even if they're fictional characters, but still, it's like when you're a kid or a teenager, you don't relate, you don't think about scenes like this the same way.
Remember the path I walked. Tifa missed her step. I ran to her, but didn't make it in time. Both of us fell off the cliff. Back then, I only scarred my knees, but...
Huh? Cloud! Why'd you bring Tifa to a place like this? What the hell's the matter with you? What if she dies?
Tifa was in a coma for 7 days.
Oh, repeating it.
We all thought she wouldn't make it. If only I could have saved her. I was so angry. angry at myself for my weakness. Ever since then, I felt Tifa blamed me. I got out of control. I'd get into fights, not even caring who it was.
Yeah, that's in the very beginning of the game. Tifa mentioned that you used to get into fights at the drop of a hat.
Yeah.
That was the first time I heard about Sephiroth. If I got strong like Sephiroth, then everyone might. If I could just get stronger, then even Tifa would have to notice me.
So that was it. Sorry, Cloud. If I had only remembered more clearly what happened, I could have done something sooner.
It's not your fault, Tifa.
But I remember back when we were 8. That's it. Now I know. You weren't created 5 years ago. My childhood memories weren't all made up. Hang in there, Cloud. Just a little longer. You've almost find the real you. Let's go back to Nibelheim again.
Yeah, this is something that... This is why those kind of artificial memory things and kind of those kinds of things really hit home with me. I have a super bad memory, and I often wonder, like, when you're kind of tossing and turning in bed, not getting sleep, I wonder about, like, what sort of butterfly effects, like, if I said something mean as a kid to somebody, what if that, like, lingered with them and it became, like, a very meaningful, negative experience to them? You never know, and you can't, like, hold yourself too accountable for stuff you've done as a kid, you know, to an extent at least. But something like that, you know, you can't blame Tifa for not recognizing Cloud, you know, going through stuff like that. People can't read minds and stuff. But it's, you know, this stuff fascinates me to no end.
The truth is right there. We almost have the answer right in the palm of our hands.
And also about memories, like, what sort of stuff do you actually remember, and what is just something that's actually, like, you think it's a memory, but it's really something that a family member might have told you happened, and then when you ask them years later after thinking it's a memory of your first-person experience, you hear that, oh, it didn't, like, happen with you present, or something like that. It's like, and also photo albums, you think you remember things, because you remember seeing photos from your childhood and stuff like that. It's kind of creepy, and or rather, there's a lot of creepy things that you need to dive in when it comes to memory. And on top of that, when you bring something like manipulation and kind of like gaslighting and things like that, like implanting like false memories through manipulation and suggestion, you know, you can really, like, make somebody, like, question, like, what the fuck, who am I, are my memories even real, and, you know, it's fascinating to no end.
Cloud, wait. Where are you going?
The reactor? To the reactor. The Mako reactor of 5 years ago.
It's Cloud!
Zack!
You remembered! That's right. It was Zack who came to Nibelheim with Sephiroth. Then, where were you, Cloud? Cloud, did you see it all?
I saw everything.
Grabs Zack's sword.
Who are you? Mom, Tifa, my town, give it back! I had so much respect for you! I admired you!
That's what happened. You were there. You were watching me. Yeah, I remember. So it was you.
Hey, oh, shit!
Yeah? I'm sure he said just something. Oh, shit. Well, you can pause. Yeah. Oh,
this is me. I never made it as a member of Soldier. I even let my hometown, I was so embarrassed I didn't want to see anybody.
Thankfully, you guys can pause the video if you want to see what the text was.
Now, incognito.
Now, Zack is like, oh, suit yourself. Thought you would like to meet everybody in your hometown.
How does it feel? It's your first time back to your hometown in a long time, right?
You came. You kept your promise. So you really did come when I was in trouble.
I didn't get there fast enough.
It's all right, Cloud.
Just like you.
Oh, he's like carrying the severed head of Genova in his hand. Like, what is the Greek mythology thing with the Medusa head like?
Mother.
Pretty brutal. Like, all he knows is that his mother is Genova and stuff. He doesn't know all the details. So, he just cuts her head off like...
The Cloud, kill Sephiroth!
True, like serial killer shit. Like, I need my mom back. I'll just take her head. Sephiroth!
Don't push your luck!
It can't be!
Sorry, that was undignified. Then that's where they both died. Cloud and Zack.
Cloud.
Then this is goodbye, Tifa. Until we meet again. Tinnitus. Shit. Kind of unpleasant.
Cloud. Tifa? Oh, Cloud, it's really you, isn't it?
Yeah, Tifa. We finally meet again.
You stupid jerk! You had us all worried sick!
Gah!
Cloud? Are you alright?
Voice! There!
I see. We're in the live stream, aren't we? Everyone's waiting. Let's go back, Cloud. Back to everyone.
Yeah. I guess so. Come on, Tifa. Let's go home.
Trippy stuff. Trippy stuff. Can't help but think that Aerith had some sort of a role in guiding them back out of the live stream into the shore. I don't know if it's implied, but I like to think so.
Yo, you all right, Tifa?
Barret? You came back? Cloud, where is he?
Don't worry about him. He's a tough one. A tough noogie.
Barret, when I was in the live stream, I saw the real Cloud. I mean, I didn't really find him. Cloud found himself on his own.
All right, I know. I shouldn't have doubted him. But I can't win against you. You're some kind of lady.
She's a lady. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
People have so many things pent up inside of themselves. And they can forget so many things. Strange, isn't it?
Yo, Tifa! Snap out of it! Tifa!
Everyone, I'm sorry. I don't know what to say.
Don't say anything, Cloud. All you've been doing is apologizing.
I never was in Soldier. I made up those stories about what happened to me 5 years ago about being in Soldier. I left my village looking for glory, but never made it into Soldier. I was so ashamed of being so weak. Then I heard this story from my friend Zack, and I created an illusion of myself made up of what I had seen in my life. And I continued to play the charade as if it were true.
Illusion, huh? Pretty damn strong for an illusion, I'd say.
I'm physically built like someone in Soldier. Hojo's plan to clone Sephiroth wasn't that difficult. It was just the same procedure they use when creating members of Soldier. You see, someone in Soldier isn't simply exposed to Mako energy. Their bodies are actually injected with Genova cells. For better or worse, only the strong can enter Soldier. It has nothing to do with the Genova reunion, but weak people, like me, get lost in the whole thing. The combination of Genova cells, Sephiroth's strong will, and my own weakness are what created me. Everyone knew that. I'm Cloud. The master of my own illusionary world. But I can't remain trapped in an illusion anymore. I'm going to live my life without pretending. You're sure messed up, Cloud.
That means there ain't no difference from before.
By the way, Cloud, what are you going to do now? Don't tell me you're going to leave the ship.
I'm the reason why Meteor is falling towards us. That's why I have to do everything in my power to fight this thing.
Good! Then you're gonna keep fighting to save the planet?
It's like you always told me, Barret.
Oh, you mean that?
What? I don't understand.
There ain't no getting up of this train we're on.
There ain't no getting rid of it.
Mista no Bureku!
I don't think if I finish the story, but yeah, the guy who can drive a semi-truck like it's a superpower, his name was Mista no Bureku. Yeah, the full circle of telling that story came around.
Oh, Cloud?
Oh, I can't. Oh.
Cloud, I was deeply moved by your story. I'm really a weak person, and so Cloud really understand how you feel, Cloud. No one knows when fighting will begin, but let's get ready.
Yeah. I'm a weak person at times too, Cloud. I relate it with your story quite a bit. Or rather, we have weak moments of weakness and stuff. And that's a good, like, Cloud admitting to his weakness, his friends support him, and he finds, you know, confidence and determination in making things right. Good shit.
Listen, Cloud, we're right in the middle of the mission for the huge materia, right? I know this kind of out of the blue, but there's an underwater reactor at Junon. As far as I can see, that's the only one left. That's that. Let's go.
Yeah.
Come on, Cloud, don't fuck around. We're going to Judon, boy.
Let's do our best, Cloud.
I know how tough it is being a leader, because I've been one. Always forget who has what materia.
I'm glad you're back with us.
Escape from a world of illusions. I wonder which is better.
This kind of on the spur of the moment, but shouldn't we ought to get to Junon?
Ah, fuck off. Don't try him.
Be like, yeah. We need to move on, man. You motherfuckers. The fuck is this?
Huh? How would you even know? You don't know how tough it is getting sick on both rides. So please, just leave me alone!
I really do understand, Yuffie. When I get sick on a flight, it's a real killer. When I was a soldier, I completely forgot about my motion sickness.
Oh? Isn't there any way to prevent this?
Well, according to my research, first off, if you're nervous a lot, you won't get sick. But you can't always be nervous. With this much space, your best bet is to move around while you're riding, doing squats, just like Zach was doing in the back of the truck there. It also might be a good idea to stretch sometimes, too. But in Soldier, we spent a lot of time in trucks. That sucked. They have like a... And there's one thing you mustn't do when writing, and that is... read. I concur. Yes, I suffered from motion sickness as a kid, and reading was the worst thing. I always needed to be somewhere where I can see right out of the front window of the car, so I couldn't read and couldn't be on my phone or anything. Even to this day, I don't get motion sickness in cars unless I read. Once you get sick, there's nothing anyone can do. I know it's tough. So
you're a little better off than me, but I don't feel well.
Yeah, a good, like, binding moment between two characters. Yeah, awesome. The game is definitely, like, pointing me to go to Junon, but there's one thing I want to do before that.
Wanna go?
Oh, he's lost his...
Yee-haw!
Maybe he became, like, a professional at this point. He reached the rank of being an actual pilot, and he lost all his personality. And youthful spunk. We're gonna go to Nibelheim. First of all, I want to, like, there's a couple of things I want to check there, because this is a missable thing, and I think it's really a bummer that it's a missable thing, because if somebody was playing this for the first time and they missed what's in Nibelheim at this point in time, they would miss a big chunk of the story. Wait, that's the rocket town. Nibelheim is... No, wait. Nibelheim is there, yeah. Because here, now... you will get closure on a thing with Tifa, and you'll get closure with something having to do with Cloud and Zack. And it's madness that this is skippable. I hope there's not enough like glare. The sun is starting to get pretty strong out. So yeah, let's first go to Tifa's house. Was it this one? Yeah. There's a hidden message in her piano. From the hero. Uh, play the piano? I can't remember. Go for it. Now, how did this go? Let's say, I'll try it a little bit. I forgot. Oh, okay. It's just... okay.
Yay!
Okay, start button, end. But I know that there's, like, behind the notes. Behind the notes, there should be a message. Play the piano? What do I say? Forget it? Okay, nothing happens, yeah. Play the piano? Go for it. I forgot, okay. No, okay, it was, sorry. Oh, shit. So, let's, I do have, that's why I took Tifa with me. Go for it. I remember. Start button. Man, how do I want, oh, okay, good. I wonder what this is. Tifa's secret savings? One gil came out of the keyboard. Oh, no. No, come on now. What am I doing wrong? Come on, please, it's a good... Oh, I remember, so let's just... Man... I'll just check. I think it's in the... It's supposed to be in the piano, like, notes. But let's just comb through this room, because it's... Bummer, what? I do remember that you could just grab it. What? Is it here? There's papers and stuff here. There's a letter. No, this is the same thing I saw. Oh, man. I'm gonna try a little bit, and if I can't find it, I'll just leave and I'll explain what it is. If it's something about doing the, like some sort of right melody or something, I can't imagine how I would have ever gotten it, but... Let's try one more time. Feels weird. See, because the thing is that... Okay, I'll explain it. You get one of Tifa's best weapons. I don't know if it's her best weapon, but you get a weapon for Tifa here, hidden. It's from her martial arts teacher, the one who ran into the flaming building to save villagers and stuff. And with it is also a note. A note where he explains that when in the reactor... Zack died by Sephiroth's hand, and Cloud died by Sephiroth's hand, but Cloud also tossed Sephiroth into the lake, basically like the Emperor in Star Wars in Return of the Jedi, and he fell into basically the life stream. He became a traveler in the life stream because he fell into that whole liquidy stuff in there, and basically, the only one left was Tifa. She was wounded and leaning on the pods. And her martial arts teacher came in and was like being really sorry that he couldn't help anyone but Tifa. And he grabbed her and used like cure magic on her as much as possible. And then he says that he couldn't like save her life. The wound would keep coming back, and his cure magic wasn't good enough, so he took her to Midgar, where doctors patched her up, and that's how she survives, and that's how, you know, you
then you get the item, you know, from that. But that's like if anybody's left wondering, like, how did Tifa survive and why isn't there like a giant gash and scar on her chest and stuff like that? It's because she was given like CPR through magic, like, and doctors like healed her up. Nobody has materia, but then again, these guys are supposed to be like pretty much pansies by now, but I'm still gonna run. I don't wanna spend time with these guys. But yeah, that's something where you would have gotten closure with Tifa. And I gotta tell you, Tifa is a character I wrongfully kind of misjudged her. When I said earlier that I have like these tiers of my favorite characters in this game when it comes to the party members, and Tifa was in my mid-tier, now Tifa is in my top tier, like alongside Barret and Red 13, and also Cloud, I would say. And in the mid-tier, there's only Cid now, and in the bottom, or an Aerith, and in the bottom tier, there's still Vincent and Kate Sith and Yuffie. Even though I love voicing Yuffie, it's still, she's not my cup of tea. Anyway, I misremembered Tifa being basically the sort of character who exists to be a contrast to Cloud. I misremembered her being basically like in a comedy they use the term straight man, that when Cloud is being like, like all sorts of like, kind of like rough and mean and kind of uncaring, and when he starts to like freak out and have all his moments, that Tifa would just be there to be the normal person to reflect and elevate Cloud's strange behavior that way. I had completely forgotten some of her best like character qualities being like these kind of negative qualities that make her a three-dimensional character, because for the longest time, I think ever since Cosmo Canyon, she's brought up this kind of wonderings and questions about whether or not she should be frank and forthright about what she is afraid is kind of going on with Cloud, and she chooses not to. And she's been doing that ever since then. And she's also been constantly pointing out that she's basically like always been the way where she's faced with tough decisions, she kind of like covers up and becomes like indecisive, and kind of like she gets like analysis paralysis, and she's kind of like, you know, she's scared of conflict and scared of like confrontation, and she would much rather bury her head in the sand and delude herself and fall into like delusions of like, oh, everything's fine, let's just pretend everything's fine, like just put on a happy face and imagine nothing's wrong kind of thing, instead of facing up to confrontation with about Cloud and stuff. That's what was going on with in her childhood when her mother died. She would she didn't want to accept, you know, her mother's passing, so she wound up making, you know, dumb decisions that caused pain to those around her, mostly Cloud. And in her adult life, she's doing it again, where she is causing pain to Cloud because she doesn't want to confront the problems. She wants to, you know, avoid it and bury her head in the sand. And also, selfish way of how she basically implanted those memories onto Cloud. You know, Cloud coming to the town of Nibelheim, and, you know, Tifa getting slashed and falling into a coma and stuff, and then waking up in Midgar and, you know, coming across by chance, you know, Cloud in the train platform, and Cloud is being all like out of it, and being like in the middle of having like a psychotic episode or something, like being all like out of it, and Tifa starts to do, like, instead of, like, accepting reality, she starts to immediately delude herself, and what she does is she basically harms Cloud by implanting these memories on him, and what she does is kind of like what people do sometimes when they manipulate kids. When a kid needs to, like, basically, like, testify in court, there's a reason why you keep usually the parents kind of away from the kids, because what the parents usually do is that they talk to the kids do you remember seeing the red car? And do you remember seeing that the car had a broken windshield? And do you remember that that Uncle Jared was in the car? And do you remember how Uncle Jared had, like, a bloody nose? And that sort of thing. Like, instead of asking what they saw, they're feeding them things to just say yes to, because usually the kids are anxious and they just want to get out of the situation where they're being interrogated and they're unsure, and an adult, an authority figure, is feeding them these things. So they just grab onto those, you know, those kind of lifelines to get out of the situation, and those inform their memories. When people do wind up, like, growing up after that, they might have vivid memories, like, I remember going to the red car with a broken windshield, and Jared was there, and he had a bloody nose. And then somebody shows you, like, actually, we have evidence that Uncle Jared was on the other side of the planet, like, at that time. Actually, we have, like, security camera footage that you went into a blue car, not red car, and all these things, and you're like, my brain, you know, and that's kind of like what Cloud is going through because of Tifa, because Tifa didn't want to face up to those things. She did that to Cloud and fucked him up. Not sure what she could have done to better him at that point in time, but still, she is... all the guilt she feels is justified, and Cloud basically, like, being, like, Genova cells in him, like, picking up those things and shaping his, like, psyche to mold to those things about Tifa's memories. It's all, you know, on Tifa's shoulders, and like I said before, it might be something that a parent might feel about a kid if they bring up a kid into the world and they wind up turning out in a, you know, kind of way where maybe they have mental problems or they're struggling through life. You might wonder, like, did I have a hand in this? Because you were directly, you know, creating the memories they have in their upbringing that inform their personality, their values, and whatnot. So it's like, you know, if somebody turns out to be full of trauma and all of that sort of stuff, it's like, thanks, Dad, thanks, Mom, you know. Oftentimes. Okay, let's go. This is the scene. There's Cloud and Zack. They're cloning bats.
Hey, this is your food.
Oh. I don't have control of the dialogue skippage, so need to be quick.
Why? Oh.
here. Oh, I can't skip. Put on this. It smells a little, though. Don't complain. You look pretty good with that. Well,
yeah, he gave him his like spare uniform.
Yo, old guy, we at Midgar yet?
Sure, you're lucky I even gave you a ride. Boo.
What are you gonna do once we get to Midgar? I know what I'm gonna do. I got a place I can crash for a while. No, wait, the mother lives there too.
Ah, Eris's place. Like, go to his ex-girlfriend's place in Midgar.
Guess that's out. Yep, gotta change my plans, Colonel. No matter what I do, I might need some money first. Hey, wanna start a business? But what could we do? Espionage. Hey, Cloud. Think there's anything I'd be good at? Sneaking missions. Hey, old guy. What do you think I'd be good at?
What are you yapping about? You're still young, ain't you? Young folks should try everything. You gotta pay your dues while you're young. Go out and look for what you really want.
Try everything. That's easy for him to say. Do squats.
He does his best thinking while squatting.
Hey! Of course. I got a lot of brains and skills that other guys don't. That settles it. I'm gonna become a mercenary. Foxhound. Yeah, that's... thanks, Pops.
Hey, did you even hear a word I said?
Listen, I'm gonna become a mercenary, and that's that. Boring stuff, dangerous stuff, anything for money. I'm gonna be rich. So, Cloud, what are you gonna do?
No, wait, you got it all wrong!
Just kidding. I won't leave you hanging like that. We're friends, right? Mercenaries, Cloud. That's what you and me are gonna be. Understand, Cloud? We're gonna be pawns to save someone's worthless butt. I have questions about the flora and fauna out here.
Somebody's shooting a machine gun.
Snake!
What do you want to do with him? Forget it. Just leave him.
Rainfall comes.
Yeah, I remember when we first came to this library, we read the report that Subject A was a former soldier and he was gunned down while resisting, and Subject B was someone who was just full of Genova schmutz while Subject A was resistant to it. And Subject B was just left B because he was so out of it that he was just like, you know, not worth the trouble. Just leave him here to rot. He's like brain dead, basically. And yeah, that's what that was. So we now have basically the full story of Cloud's mysterious past. There might be some revelations still to come, but most likely just tiny ones, but that's the main gist of it all. Cloud was born in Nibelheim. Cloud came on this mission with Zack. He died during the mission, as well as Zack did as well, and they were both cloned and created artificially right after that, and Cloud was a gibbering mess, full of Genova schmutz, and Zack was resistant to the Genova schmutz, and he saved Cloud, gave him his spare clothes, and was gunned down, and Cloud grabbed his sword and ended up in the train platform just drooling on himself, just and that's where Tifa found him and started implanting all those memories on him. Well, those memories might be the things that basically woke him up. And yeah, let's use a tent. I don't think I got any new weapons. And I should have bought Cloud a fresher weapon. I wonder what he was. Organics. That was still good. I'm gonna give him the luck thing. That was on. Yeah, basically I need to PHS. I need to grab red, and I need to basically remove. Let's first remove amulet so that I can give that to Cloud, and then let's. There. And let's PHS. Now let's equip the materia stuff. Oh, wait. Amulet. Luck. Aurora armlet. Yeah. Aurora armlet has pretty poor. What about the. Oh, I didn't take the. I didn't take the. What was it, like, crystal? Armlet. Red, yeah. Let's just put whatever on him. And then. This might be a little tedious, but. It's the name of the game. Whoops. Crystal bangle. It's worse than. But it has more slots. It's not worse by such a long shot. It's, well, it kinda is. My god. What's this? Wizard bracelet. Wizard bracelet is. Oh no, look at the defense. It goes from 76 to 6. My god. I'm keeping the Aurora armlet. It drains cold attacks. That's not gonna be a big thing, but the stats alone are nice. Let's take, again, sorry about this, it's gonna take a long time again, but yeah, I just basically, this helps me think. Okay, so, Sid is going to be the time guy, and both Barret and, both Barret and Cloud are going to have Restore All. There. And Cloud is going to have.
Well, he'll have cover. He will have. Let's first give him, like, the stuff. Enemy skill. I'm not gonna bother with the death blow thing. Let's give him. I'm gonna need to give him, like, the luck plus. What? Luck plus and counterattack. Those need to go on him. Counterattack, luck plus. There you go. And then he needs some attacks. Let's give him ice and lightning. There. And then let's give him a couple of summons. Let's give him... Oh yeah, now I got the Phoenix. I have no idea how good it is. I don't know if it's something that could have been gotten earlier in the game and it's trash. But I'll just... I'll give Cloud Odin and Neo Bahamut. There. And Barret is going to have... Barret is going to have another cover. He's going to have... he's going to have fire, earth, and poison. And he's going to have Big Pig. And let's give him... Let's give him the other Bahamut for now, and let's check up on Sid. He's gonna have... Let's give him the Phoenix. I'm not gonna bother with Ifrit anymore. Leviathan. Let's give him Ultima! Let's give him also... also, Shiva might just stay behind... enemy skill. Ah, and then the MP Turbo Comet. He has Comet and he has Ultimatum. Those are not elemental. Let's give him Fire. Let's give him two Steels to add to his Dexterity. And... okay, like the last thing. Okay, let's give him one more summon. Ramu and Titan came later. Let's give him Titan. There. Now I think everything is fine, so I'm gonna save now, and before I go to Junon for the whole submarine stage of the game, I'm gonna grind a little bit and get the characters up a little bit, because the weapon already was kicking my ass a little bit, and I'm feeling kind of anxious about that, but we'll see, and... We'll get to that next time.